Okay.
You all set?
Yep.
Rise up every morning at 7:45. Some woman who's my wife tells me not to be late. I kiss the kids goodbye, I can't remember their names. And week after week, it's always the same. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line.
Yeah.
And it's code in the data. Give the keyboard a punch. Then cross, correlate, and a break for some lunch. Correlate, tabulate, process, and screen. Program, print out, regress to the mean. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Yeah. Then it's home again, eat again, watch some TV, make love to your woman at 10:53. I dream the same dream when I'm sleeping at night. I'm soaring over hills like an eagle in flight. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Yeah. Someday I'm gonna give up all the buttons and things. I'll punch that time clock till it can't ring. Burn up my necktie and set myself free. Cause no one's gonna fold, bend, or mutilate me. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? Woo! And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. And it's, oh boys, can't you code it? And program it right. Nothing ever happens in this life of mine. I'm hauling up the data on the Xerox line. Wildcats yell, how I love that place, no one can tell. There are trout streams there, and moose and deer, but you never lay eyes on a grizzly bear. They come back up on your back, and head your way up the lookout track. Poor old bones are stiff and cold. I'll head to the lookout with the setting sun. And when I smell those spruce trees, I'll feel young. When the creeks are frozen, the lakes are high, and you hear the owl in the brook like cry, I'll head to the lookout with the spirit sign. Goodbye, my friend, if there I'll die. Not far away, we all know well, the place that's called the Lookout Hill, where the rabbits hop, the wildcats yell, how I love that place, no one can tell. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That song was written in 1938 by the chief forestry officer for Antigonish County, Nova Scotia.
Who also happens to be our uncle. That's why we do the tune. Uncle Lee is kind of a neat guy. I have to talk while Jim goes and changes his guitar cord. It went away on vacation. Uncle Lee's kind of a neat guy. He's sort of a backwoods Renaissance man. And as well as being a forestry officer, he makes canoes and guitars in his spare time. They sound much the same. He's actually responsible for making Stan's very first instrument. It's a lovely guitar, about the size of my fiddle, and it's made out of 3/4-inch birch plywood. Beautiful guitar.
It is a wonderful machine. The frets, instead of being the normal fret wire material, it's 3/8-inch brass brazing rod. Wonderful stuff. And the original nut and saddle were carved from an old toothbrush. Somebody once suggested that I grow flowers in it.
It's got really beautiful inlay on it, all up and down the fretboard, out of mother of toilet seat. It's love that guitar.
Yeah, and then the pickguard is mother of linoleum too. Yeah, it's a great guitar. I still play it. I hang it on the wall of my living room, and I still play it from time to time. I even played it on national television in Canada one night.
All right, go ahead.
All right. This next song. I can see I'm going to have trouble with him tonight. This next song was a sort of a posthumous collaboration. The lyrics were written by the 19th century English novelist, clergyman, and poet Charles Kingsley. The music for this song was written by a certain violinist of my acquaintance.
It was very difficult getting in touch with Mr. Kingsley. We were communicating via Ouija board for a while. And
hey, you've been communicating with spirits for a long time. 3 Fishers. Three fishers went sailing out into the west, out into the west as the sun went down. Each thought on the woman that loved him the best. Children stood watching them out of the town. For men must work and women must weep for this little to earn, and there's many to keep. And the harbor bar be mounted, and the harbor. Lighthouse tower, and they trimmed the lamps as the sun went down, and they looked at the squall, and they looked at the showers, and the night rock came rolling in ragged and brown. For men must work and men must weep, those storms be sodden and the waters deep, and the harbor bar be moaning, and the harbor bar be three corpses lay out on the shining sand. In the morning gleam as the tide went down, and the women were weeping and wringing their hands for those who would never come back to the town. For men must work and men must weep, and the sooner it's over, the sooner to sleep. And goodbye to the bar and its moaning, and goodbye to the bar and its moaning. For men must work and men must weep, and the sooner it's over, the sooner to sleep. And goodbye to the bar and its moaning, and goodbye to the bar and its moaning. Dark rose, feel the trickle in your clothes, blow the dust cake from your nose, hear the tractor's steady roar. Oh, you can't stop now, there's a quarter section more or less to go. And it figures that the rain keeps its own sweet time. Watch it come for miles, so you guess you've got a while, and ease the throttle out of air. Every rod's a gain, there's victory in every quarter mile. For oh, goes it down the road, the heartache came and hoppers brought him down. Gave it up and went to town. Emmett Sears the other day took a heart attack and died at 42. You could see it coming on, 'cause he worked as hard as you. In an hour, maybe more, you'll be wet clear through. The air is cooler now. Pull your hat brim further down and wash the field behind the plow. Turn to straight dark rows. Put another season's promise in the ground. And if the harvest's any good, the money just might cover all the loans. You've mortgaged all you own. Buy the kids a winter coat. Take the wife back east for Christmas if you can. All summer she hangs on. When you're so tied to the land. good times come and go, but at least there's rain, so this won't be barren ground when September rolls around. So watch the field behind the plow turn to straight dark rows, put another season's promise in the ground.
Try that now.
Watch the field behind the plow turn to straight dark rows, put another season's promise in the ground.
Thank you very much. This next tune is sort of a more regional song. It deals with the inshore fishery. And one of my very favorite songs of Stan's. It's also the very longest song that we have in our whole repertoire. It'll be the last tune we're doing tonight. We'd like to thank you all for coming out to see us. We'll be taking a break, I guess, between the 37th and 38th verses.
Come all you lads, draw near to me, that I be not forsaken. This day was lost, the Jeanie C, my living has been taken. I'll go to sea no more. We set out this day in the bright sunrise, the same as any other. My son and I and old John Price in the boat named for my mother. I'll go to sea no more. Well, you know what the fishing has been. It's been scarce and hard and cruel. But this day, by God, we sure caught cod. And we sang and we laughed like fools. I'll go to sea no more. I'll never know what it was we struck, but strike we did like thunder. Christ gave a cry and pitched overside. Now it's forever he's gone under. I'll go to sea no more. Now a leak we've sprung, let there be no delay. If the genie sees, we're safe. along the whole while you're bailing. I'll go but no hole I found from bow to hold. No rock it was that got her. But what I found made my heart stop cold. For every seam poured water, I'll go to sea no more. My God, I cried as she went down. That boat was like no other. My father built her when I was 9 and named her for my mother. I'll go to sea no more. And sure, I could have another mate in the boat shop down in Dover, but I would not love the keel they made like the one away.
A lot of songs to get through here tonight. Up, okay. 2, 3, 4. Where the earth shows its bones of wind, broken stone, and the sea and the sky are one. Caught out of time, my blood sings with wine, and I'm running naked in the sun. There's God in the trees, I'm weak in the knees, and the sky is a painful blue. I'd like to look around, but honey, all I see is you. Summer city lights will soften the night, do you think that the air is clear? And I'm sitting with friends where 45 cents will buy another glass of beer. And he's got something to say, but I'm so far away that I don't know who I'm talking to. Cause you just walked in the door, and honey, all I see is you. And I just want to hold you closer than I've ever had.
twice a wife and you're true as life. Oh, but honey, what the hell's it for? After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow. But I want to see your smiling face 45 years from now. Lights on stage every night, I've been reaching out to find a friend who knows all the words, sings so she's heard and knows how all the stories end. And maybe after the show she'll ask me to go home with her for a drink or two. Now her smile lights her eyes, but honey, all I see is you. And I just wanna hold you closer than I've ever held anyone before. You say you've been twice a wife and you're true as life. Oh, but honey, what the hell's it for? After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow. But I wanna see you smiling face 45 years from now. I just wanna hold you closer than I've ever held anyone before. You say you've been twice a wife and you're through with life. Oh, but honey, what the hell's it for? After 23 years, you think I could find a way to let you know somehow that I wanna see your smiling face 45 years from now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Watching cities rise before me, then behind me sink again. This tardiest explorer, driving hard across the plain, for just just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. And through the night, behind the wheel, the mileage clicking west, I think upon Mackenzie, David Thompson, and the rest, who cracked the mountain ramparts and did show a path for me to race the roaring Fraser to the sea. For just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea. How then am I so different from the first men through this way? Like them, I left a settled life, I threw it all away to seek a Northwest Passage at the call of many men, and find there but the road back home again. I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the
songbirds you are.
Well, I can see you've been practicing. I was saying to someone out front tonight before the show started that someone was asking me, you know, is it okay if we sing tonight? And I said, yeah, as long as you sing the same song we're singing. And it's particularly gratifying when that happens, people sing the same song. I noticed a few of you out there who have obviously been exposed to the traditional singer type of a cappella singing where you sing with your eyes firmly closed and your one hand firmly clasped over one ear in order that you don't have to listen to your neighbor.
There were
a few of you, however, that didn't have it quite down, and I'd like to point this out to you. You were out there with, you know, hand over the eye doesn't really do it.
Okay.
Thank you.
I often take these night shift walks when the foreman's not around. I turn my back on the coolin' stacks and make for open ground. Far out beyond the tank farm fence where the gas flare makes no sound. I forget the stink and I always think back to that Easter town. I remember back 6 years ago, Western life I chose. And every day the news would say some factory's going to close. Well, I could have stayed to take the dough, but I'm not one of those. I take nothing free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. Going in farewell to the eastern town I never more will see. At work I'm up, so I eat the dust and breathe refinery. Oh, I miss the green and the woods and streams, and I don't like cowboy clothes. But I like being free, and that makes me an idiot, I suppose. Young fellers who've been beaten to the ground. This western life's no paradise, but it's better than lying down. Oh, the streets aren't clean and there's nothing green, and the hills are dirty brown. But the government dole will rot your soul back there in your hometown. Oh, bid farewell to the eastern town you never more will see. There's self-respect and a steady check in this refinery. You'll miss the green and the woods and streams, and the dust will fill your nose. But you'll be free and just like me, an idiot, I suppose.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, I once made a promise to myself that I would never write a totally political song. I've often thought that politics really doesn't have an awful lot of place on the stage. People pay an exorbitant amount of money to come out and hear somebody perform.
Particularly in our case.
In our case, yeah. They don't want to be lectured. You can get that at home. But a friend of mine took a little trip to England. It was the first time she'd been home to England in 20 years. Her first day in London, she decided to do a little sightseeing before she went north to see her folks. So she was taking some pictures of the horse guards going through the park. And the car she was standing beside blew up. So a single mother of two teenage daughters is, courtesy of the IRA, making with one leg now. I don't care what your religion is or what your politics are or what cause you believe in, which side of the quarrel you agree with. The fact remains, when there are dead kids lying on the ground, all those causes have to go out the window. None of them mean a damn anymore. It's been 293 years since the Battle of the Boyne. I think that's long enough to hold a grudge. This is called the House of Orange.
I took back my hand and I showed him the door. No dollar of mine would I part with this day for fueling the engine of a bloody cruel war. In my forefather's home far away, who fled the first famine wearing all that they owned, were called navigators all ragged and torn, and built the Grand Trunk here and found a new home. Wherever their children were born, their sons have no politics none can recall, an allegiance to long generations before. Oh, this or oh, that name can't matter at all. For because enough for to war, and meanwhile my babies are safe in their home. Unlike their pale cousins who cower and cry, while kneecappers nail their poor dads to the floor, and teach them to hate and to die. Now it's these cruel beggars who spurn the fair coin. The peace for their kids they could take at their will, since the day old King Billy prevailed at the point. They've bombed and they've maimed and they've killed. Now they cry out for money and wail at the door. But home rule or republic, 'tis all of it shame, and a curse for us here who want nothing of war. We're kindred in nothing but name. For causes are ashes where children lie slain. Yet the damned UDL and the cruel IRA will tomorrow go murdering again. But no penny of mine will I add to the fray. Remember the boyne, they will cry out in vain, for I've given my heart to the place I was born, and forgiven the whole House of Orange, King Billy and the whole House of Orange. Thank you. Now for something entirely different.
This is a 500-year-old ballad written by a friend of ours. He's getting on.
On the field, saying that water cold and clear will never clean your wound. There's none but the witch of the Westmorland can make thee hay that so. Oh, turn, turn your stallion's head till his red mane flies in the wind. Come the rider of the moon goes by and the bright star falls behind. And here was the paling moon, but his shadow passed him by. Fill all the hill with the brightest stars when he heard the owl and cry. Saying, why do you ride this way? And wherefore can you hear? I seek the witch of the Westmorland, who goes for the winding here. It's weary by the old water, in the misty brake burn way. Till through the cleft of the curtain, past the winding waterway. He said, lie down, my brindle town, and rest ye, make a grey hawk, and be my steed, my grey sight, where I must dismount and walk. But come when you hear my horn, and answer swift the call, for I fear the sun will rise this morn, you will serve me best of all. It's down to the water's brim, he's borne the rowan's shield, and the golden rod he has cast in the sea with the lake by steel. And back rose she from the lake, fast asleep went she. One half the form of a maiden fair with a jet black hair's body. And loud along the trill he flew, till his feet was by his side. High overhead the grey hawk flew, swiftly he did ride. Singing chorus from the brindle town, fetch me the jet black mare. Stoop and strike me good grey hawk and bring me the maiden fair. She said, pray, sheathe thy silvery sword, lay down the rowan shield, for I see by the briny blood that flows you've been wounded in the field. She stood in a gown of a velvet blue, bound round the silver chain. She's kissed his pale lips once and twice, and three times round again. She's bound his wound with the golden rod, oh, fast in her arms he lay. And he has risen hale and sound with the sun high in the day. And ride with your brindle down the hill, and your good grey hawk in hand.
Yeah.